And Tom, also making news tonight, we are 1 week away from the Vermont legislature voting on extending the life of Vermont Yankee.
Today we got a look inside the troubled power plant. News Channel 5, Stuart Ledbetter is live in Vernon. And Stu, this was not your typical company tour now, was it?
Oh, no, certainly not, Stephanie. Really fascinating, especially after hearing about this place for so many years, to get inside some of the most secure areas of the nuclear plant behind me and see who you'd meet along the way.
Past the most secure entrance with armed guards and screening technology that would put any airport to shame sits the almost 40-year-old nuclear plant known as Vermont Yankee. 650 people work here, among them Dwayne Jackson, who started in 1983.
I wouldn't be here this long and live this close. I live in Vernon if I didn't trust this plant or the people that work here.
Jackson makes sure employees and visitors don't pick up any radiation while inside the reactor building, which was built by General Electric in 1972.
You're standing on top of our reactor, Stuart, at 100% power, 620 megawatts.
There's no vibration or any sense at all.
Yeah.
Nearby, spent fuel rods sit in a warm pool of water. We were escorted the whole time, but with no restrictions on where we could go.
There are a lot of signs inside a nuclear plant. When you see one of these, you keep moving.
Outside the reactor building sits some of the overflow waste in concrete reinforced containers known as dry casks. The Connecticut River is less than 100 feet away.
I supervise the resident inspector staff here, but
we happen to run into Don Jackson, the senior inspector with the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, who is responsible for Yankee.
Assuming that the maintenance is done, which we monitor, and the maintenance is done effectively, the plant can operate throughout its 40-year lifetime and potentially the 20 years longer if the license is extended.
The NRC and the Vermont legislature get to weigh in on that. But the staff that works here hopes to keep doing what they're doing for a long time to come.
And I'm just hoping that it's not just a money issue to them. You know, I hope they understand that we're real people down here, real jobs, you know, and they need to understand that.
Bill Reardon, a union mechanic, like most we met here, says he'll move his family if the plant is shut down. For now.
We've been telling them, don't let this be a distraction.
But the employees that we met here are very mindful of next week's vote in the state senate in Montpelier. We're also struck here this afternoon by all of the construction-type work that is underway at this plant, both to rebuild those cooling towers and the very delicate excavation work to try to find the source of that tritium leak, something that Entergy and the NRC are anxious to find. We're live in Vernon tonight. Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.